Well, this is new tonight. A Placerville kayaker is being called a hero after an SUV carrying a family of five lost control, smashed into a tree and then some rocks, and ended up in the middle of a Sierra River.
But as the Night Team's Richard Sharp shows us, the kayaker was in the right place at the right time.
This is where it ended, the middle of the American River. But that SUV, firemen and witnesses say, went off Highway 50, hit this mile marker,
pushed it 6 feet,
hit this tree,
they must have been airborne,
smashed into these boulders, moving them before the SUV was launched into the air, carrying a family of five.
They must have done at least one complete flip.
Flipped up in the air and landed in the river on its passenger side.
Mark DiVittorio is a real estate agent who loves to kayak and has had emergency medical training.
It's fortuitous that they didn't actually land on me. I was kayaking right there moments before they plunged off this cliff and landed right there in the river.
DiVittorio raced to help. He was able to get three children to safety. He went back to find the driver pinned upside down, his head being held out of the water by his wife. He was struggling to breathe, losing consciousness, and trying to talk to his wife for what could have been the last time.
And I was afraid that if I cut the seatbelt, he would have died in front of me and his wife and his three kids.
By chance, a fire truck with swift water-trained firemen was nearby. With a response time of only 3 minutes instead of the normal 15, they were able to get to the driver and stabilize him quickly.
We actually used a life jacket to put underneath his head and shoulders to hold his head up out of the water while we were cutting the roof off.
All this in ice-cold water, but the family is lucky.
The lack of rainfall this year actually worked in favor of this family. The water wasn't as high as it normally is, wasn't as swift as it normally is.
All five family members were taken to area hospitals, firefighters say. Only the driver suffered major injuries.
He wanted to live. He wanted to be with his family.
In the Sierra, I'm Richard Sharp, KCRA 3 Night Team.
The fire department says another reason the family in that SUV had so few injuries was because they were all wearing their seatbelts. Investigators are now looking into what caused that vehicle to veer.